Assalamu alaikum. My name is Birza Maryam from the Department of BS Biotechnology. The topic of my presentation is electron energy loss spectroscopy, and the part of my presentation is instrumentation. To begin with the presentation, I would like to present the abstract. Electron energy loss spectroscopy is an analysis of the distribution of the electron energy emergent from a thin specimen due to its inelastic interaction. An electron energy loss spectroscopy spectrum contains a great deal of information about the specific atoms, not only what they are chemically, but also their electronic structures, their bonding states, nearest neighbor distributions, coordination numbers, dielectric constants, and band gaps. These characteristics are observed in different energy regions depending on the energy loss. Electron energy loss spectroscopy is the use of the energy distribution of electrons that pass through a thin sample to analyze the content of the sample and create images with unique contrast effects. Electron energy loss spectroscopy instrumentation is typically incorporated into a transmission electron microscope or scanning transmission electron microscope. These microscope types use high electron energy, 60 to 300 kilowatt typically, to interrogate the sample. As the name implies, the electrons must transmit through the sample and thus requires an electron transparent sample. The electrons can interact either elastically, no energy exchange, or inelastically with the sample. And it is these interactions that electron energy loss spectroscopy exploits to extract information about the sample. Next, the monochromatic electron energy loss spectroscopy is one of the leading techniques to study materials properties that correspond to low energy losses, that is, band gaps, plasmons, and excitons, with nanoscale spatial resolution. Recently, new generations of monochromators have become available, opening reagents and unblocking excitations that are previously unobservable in the electron microscope. The points which are going to discuss in our presentation are history, introduction, instrumentation detail, applications, and limitations. The first one is history. The technique was developed by James Hillier and R.F. Baker in the mid-1940s, but was not widely used over the next 50 years, only becoming more widespread in research in the 1990s due to advances in microscope instrumentation and vacuum technology. With modern instrumentation becoming widely available in the laboratories worldwide, the technical and scientific developments from the mid-1990s have been rapid. The technique is also able to take advantage of modern aberration corrected probe forming systems to attain spatial resolutions down to approximate 0.1 nanometer, while with a monochromatic electron source and or careful link convolution, the electron resolution can be 0.1 electron volt or better. This has enabled detailed measurements of the atomic and electronic properties of single columns of atoms, and in a few cases of single atoms. The next part is introduction to spectroscopy. This presentation will focus on the use of electron energy loss spectroscopy in a transmission electron microscope or a scanning transmission electron microscope. In a transmission electron microscope or scanning transmission electron microscope, a beam of electrons is accelerated to energies typically between 100 kilo electron volt and 1 mega electron volt. The beam of electrons is transmitted through a sample that consists of a thin piece of material, typically less than 50 nanometer thickness. Interaction of the beam with the sample enables the operator to learn something about the sample, such as chemical elements present, stoichiometry energy levels, electronic structure, and more. The electron energy loss spectroscopic technique focuses on the inelastic interaction of the primary beam electrons with the electrons from the sample. The loss of energy of the primary electrons that is commonly used in electron energy loss spectroscopy is in the range of 0 electron volt to 3 kilo electron volt. This energy loss is measured by using the dispersive properties of a homogeneous magnetic field on the charged electrons in an electron energy loss spectrometer or magnetic spectrometer. Next is instrumentation, which is the main part of my presentation. The instrument used in electron energy loss spectroscopy is magnetic spectrometer. Electron energy loss spectroscopy instrumentation is typically incorporated into a transmission electron microscope or scanning transmission electron microscope. These microscope types use high electron energy, 60 to 300 kilovolt typically, to interrogate the sample. Now, this is the diagram of the electron energy loss spectrometer instrument. We're going to discuss this instrument in detail in the upcoming slides. Magnetic spectrometer. Magnetic spectrometer discriminates the energy loss electrons on the basis of their absolute energy. The first part of magnetic spectrometer is electron gun. The electron beam generator, which corresponds to a light source of the optical microscope. The electron gun emits electrons from the cathode. These electrons are accelerated to one anode to produce an electron beam. The second part is condenser lens. The condenser lens consists of two lenses. The first lens demagnetizes the crossover of the electron beam emitted from the electron gun to approximate 1 over 10 in size. The second lens transfers the demagnetized beam onto the object plane of the objective lens with a magnification of approximately 1%. The third part is aberration corrector. Resolution of scanning electron microscope is determined by aberrations of the objective lens. It is well known that both spherical and chromatic aberrations can be compensated by placing a 90 degree bending magnet and an electron mirror in the beam path before the objective lens. Nevertheless, this approach has not led to wide use of these aberration correctors, partly because aberration of the bending magnet can be a serious problem. A mirror corrector with two mirrors placed perpendicular to the optic axis of an LXM and facing each other is proposed. As a result, only small angle magnetic deflection is necessary to guide the electron beam around the top mirror of the objective lens to the bottom mirror of the objective lens. The deflection angle in the order of 50 milliradians is sufficiently small to avoid deflection aberrations. The next part is objective lens. The scanning electron microscope objective lens lies above the specimen, while that in the transmission electron microscope, it is below the specimen. The scanning electron microscope objective lens is the last lens in the series of lenses that create the electron beam that scans the specimen. This lens focuses the scanning beam to a very small spot. In the transmission electron microscope, the electron beam has passed through a specimen before it enters the objective lens. In that term, which is transmission electron microscope, the objective lens focuses the image, while in the SEM, the objective lens focuses the scanning probe. These lenses have the same name because they serve comparable functions in creating focus on the specimen, but they carry out the focusing function in different ways. The next thing is sample, which we place in electron microscope. The electron beam transmits through a sample where it loses energy by degenerating excitations. The next part of the instrument is post-specimen lenses. This lens is used to both form the beam and limit the amount of current in the beam. It works in conjunction with the condenser aperture to eliminate the high angle electrons from the beam. The next is scattered beam. The signal from secondary electrons tends to be highly localized at the point of impact of the primary electron beam, making it possible to collect images of the sample surface with a resolution of below 1 nanometer. Backscattered electrons are beam electrons that are reflected from the sample by elastic scattering. The next part is HAADF detector. This detector receives inelastically scattered electrons at high range angles that approximately 50 to sufficiently high angles, approximate 200 milliradians. The beam, which is directed, are now directed towards the magnetic prism. The last part is magnetic prism. The transmitted beam is dispersed by a magnetic prism to create a specimen of the energy loss events that occurred in the sample. Now the detector came. The beam creates a signal on the electron energy loss spectrometer detector. The signal from the electron energy loss spectrometer can be used to generate an electron energy loss spectrum. The spectrometer can be used to produce a compositional map. Now, we are going to discuss some of the applications of the electron energy loss spectroscopy technique. Electron energy loss spectroscopy is an analytical technique that is based on inelastic scattering of fast electrons in a thin specimen. In a transmission electron microscope, it can provide structural and chemical information about a specimen, even down to atomic resolutions. Electron energy loss spectroscopy, electron energy field transmission electron microscopy, and high resolution transmission electron microscopy have been applied in mineralogy and materials research to determine the oxidation states of various metals at high spatial resolution. Such information is critical in understanding the kinetics and mechanism of mineral-microbe interaction. The high sensitivity of electron energy loss spectroscopy for detecting light elements at the nanoscale makes it a valuable technique for application to biological systems. In particular, electron energy loss spectroscopy provides quantitative information about elemental distributions within subcellular compartments, specific atoms bound to individual macromolecular assemblies, and the composition of bio-nanoparticles. The electron energy loss spectroscopy data can be acquired either in the fixed beam energy filter transmission electron microscope or in the scanning transmission electron microscope. And recent progress in the development of both approaches has greatly expanded the range of applications for electron energy loss spectroscopy analysis. Near single atom sensitivity is now achievable for certain elements bound to isolated macromolecules, and it becomes possible to obtain three-dimensional composition distribution from section cell through electron energy loss transmission electron microscopy tomography. The last part of my presentation is the limitation of this technique. The main limitation of electron energy loss spectroscopy technique is the effect of the sample thickness. As the sample thickness increases, the strong interactions of primary electrons within the sample results in the electrons undergoing multiple energy loss events. This tends to reduce the signal back to ground ratio of the electron energy loss spectroscopy edges, reducing the visibility of the edges. However, since the spatial resolution of transmission electron microscope techniques is also reduced as the thickness increases, this loss of the edge visibility is not always the largest impediment to qualify data. That's all for my presentation. Thank you for your attention.